The rainforests found in Antarctica. Did you know there are rainforests in Antarctica? Yes, you heard that right. Antarctica, the frozen continent, holds a secret that few people know about. Rainforests. In this video, we will take you on a journey to explore the reality of these greens. We will also uncover the mystery surrounding these hidden ecosystems. So if you're ready to discover the unexpected and learn about the fascinating world of rainforests in Antarctica, then keep watching. Trust us, you won't want to miss what we have in store for you.
And therefore we decided to scan them in a CT scanner back home. So what we see here...
Deep in the heart of West Antarctica lies a secret that has been buried under the ice for millions of years. In a recent study, international researchers discovered that 90 million years ago, this desolate region was home to a lush, thriving temperate rainforest. How could this be possible, you may wonder? Cretaceous Period. During the middle of the Cretaceous Period, which spanned from 145 million to 65 million years ago, the world was a vastly different place. Dinosaurs roamed the Earth, and sea levels were an astounding 558 feet, 170 meters, higher than they are today. In this scorching hot climate, sea surface temperatures in the tropics were as high as 95 degrees Fahrenheit, 35 degrees Celsius. These incredibly hot conditions allowed a rainforest, similar to those found in New Zealand today, to take root in Antarctica. The remains of this rainforest were recently discovered under the ice, in a sediment core collected from a seabed near Pine Island Glacier in West Antarctica. The core was immediately identified as something unusual, as the layer that formed 90 million years ago had a different color than the layers above it. The researchers put the core into a CT scanner and were amazed at the results. The digital image showed a dense network of roots throughout the entire soil layer, as well as ancient pollen, spores, and the remnants of flowering plants from the Cretaceous period. The team of researchers, including a geologist and a paleontologist, analyzed the pollen and spores to reconstruct the 90 million year old vegetation and climate of West Antarctica. They found that the coast was once a dense, temperate, swampy forest, similar to the forests found in New Zealand today. Mid-Cretaceous period. The study revealed that during the mid-Cretaceous, West Antarctica had a mild climate, with an annual mean air temperature of about 54 degrees Fahrenheit, 12 degrees Celsius, similar to that of Seattle. Summer temperatures were even warmer, with an average of 66 Fahrenheit, 19 Celsius, and in rivers and swamps, the water temperature would have reached up to 68 Fahrenheit, 20 Celsius. In addition, the rainfall was comparable to the rainfall of Wales, England today. The researchers found that the carbon dioxide concentration in the atmosphere during the Cretaceous was even higher than previously thought, and it took concentration levels of 1,120 to 1,680 ppm to reach the average temperatures back then in Antarctica. These findings suggest how potent greenhouse gases can cause temperatures to skyrocket, resulting in a lush rainforest in a region that is now frozen. Plants. Talking about the forest, let's find out what kind of plant fossils scientists found that made them think that Antarctica was a rainforest. In the icy continent of Antarctica, well-preserved fossils from now extinct glossopterous trees have been discovered. These ancient relics are a vital piece of evidence that has helped scientists to piece together the concept of Gondwana, which formed approximately 550 million years ago, was not just any ordinary landmass. It was actually a supercontinent, often referred to as one of the largest in the world. But that's not all, folks. When Robert Falcon Scott and his team were tragically found dead in their tent on the way back from the South Pole, specimens of Glossopterus from the Beardmore Glacier region were discovered with them. Despite jettisoning almost everything else, they recognized the incredible importance of these specimens and refused to leave them behind. And get this, these specimens are a jaw-dropping 280 to 300 million years old. But wait, there's more. Many of these plants that can still be found in the cold, temperate rainforests of Tasmania, New England, and southern South America were once present in Antarctica. It's crystal clear that these plants continued to thrive in Antarctica until about 35 million years ago. One of them are abundant remains of the Nothofagus, commonly known as southern beeches, have been found a mere 400 kilometers from the South Pole, and get this, the remains may be as young as 2 to 3 million years old. But these weren't the only living things found in the icy parts of the Antarctica rainforest.
It was found on the Beardmore Glacier several hundred miles from the South Pole on the way back.
Dinosaurs of the forest. Dinosaurs, long extinct, once roamed the southernmost continent, their existence shrouded in mystery. While their remains have been uncovered in the northern tip of the Antarctic Peninsula, only a handful have been officially cataloged, including the armored ankylosaurus and two marine reptilian groups, the mosasaurs and the plesiosaurs. But one remote location holds the key to unlocking the past, Seymour Island. The Seymour Islands are a group of small islands located off the northern tip of the Antarctic Peninsula. This fossil-rich site is one of the most significant in the world, boasting a vast assortment of fossils representing diverse environments. It is also home to one of the few uninterrupted sections across the Cretaceous-Tertiary boundary, the time when the dinosaurs and other life forms disappeared, possibly due to a catastrophic event, like a meteorite or asteroid impact. Marine Plain, situated in the Vestfold Hills, holds a trove of secrets as well. The Vestfold Hills are a coastal area located in East Antarctica, just east of the Amory Ice Shelf. They consist of a group of low-laying hills and valleys that are almost entirely covered in ice, with only a few exposed ridges and summits. Fossils from 4.5 to 4.1 million years ago are abundant, with the best known belonging to ancient dolphins and whales. These creatures, unlike their modern counterparts, lack teeth and may have hunted using echolocation to locate squid, sucking them into their slim jaws. Nearly complete skeletons of these enigmatic creatures lie scattered across the plain, as though they died and sank softly into the mire. However, a dark chapter looms in the history of Antarctica, shrouded in mystery. Around 2 to 3 million years ago, a cataclysmic event occurred, resulting in the extinction of many species. The Isthmus of Panama, also known as the Isthmus of Darien, is a slim slice of land that connects North and South America. What's more, it's at the center of a heated debate among experts over its formation. But one thing they do agree on is that the closure of the isthmus caused a major shakeup in our planet's climate. Yep, you heard that right. This little strip of land altered the course of history. By halting the flow of water between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans, the Isthmus of Panama gave birth to the Gulf Stream and Northern Hemisphere glaciation, two climate phenomena that have had a massive impact on our world. And let's not forget about Panama itself, which makes its home on this remarkable isthmus, along with the world-famous Panama Canal. The growing Himalayas may have also impacted atmospheric circulation in the Northern Hemisphere, contributing to this global extinction event. Rainforest reboot. Is there any possibility that Antarctica turns back into a rainforest? It's a fascinating question, but unfortunately, the answer is not that simple. There are many factors that need to align perfectly for this to happen. One of the biggest obstacles is the current location of Antarctica, as it needs to shift back to where it was 80 million years ago in order to be in a favorable zone for rainforest growth. But hold on a second, because scientists have made an incredible discovery that could change everything. They have recently created the first ever large-scale map of microscopic algae as they bloomed across the surface of snow along the Antarctic Peninsula coast. This so-called green snow is caused by massive amounts of these tiny algae growing together, turning the snow a vibrant shade of green. And guess what? As global temperatures increase, it's likely that this green snow will continue to spread.
Snow surface, and if you look over here, you can see there's patches of green.
The team behind this groundbreaking research includes researchers from the University of Cambridge and the British Antarctic Survey, who used a combination of satellite data and on-the-ground observations to detect and measure the green snow algae. Although each individual algae is microscopic in size, when they grow in huge numbers, they can be seen from space, and that's pretty amazing if you ask us. So to sum it all up, Antarctica was never like it is now. It used to be a hustling and bustling rainforest with many dinosaurs and a beautiful forest. The climate change caused by the movement of Earth's continents turned it into a winter land. As climate change warms the region and shrinks its enormous ice sheet, many scientists are wondering what other long-buried treasures may be revealed. It's still a mystery waiting to be uncovered.